Good morning and welcome to the Norton Ways YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be introducing you to the new MG4. So let's just take a quick walk around the outside before we go for a drive. So you've got the LED running lights here. Very elegant looking car, quite sporty looking. Car comes with alloy wheels, hidden behind plastic covers. LED indicators on the outside here. Keyless entry. Keyless start, easiest car to drive in the world. Five-door hatchback, good size, fully electric vehicle. Comes in two different ranges, short range or long range. Just under 200 miles on combined cycle for the short range. And close to 300 on the long range. So let's jump in and go for a drive. So off we go. Easiest car in the world to drive. Just put your foot on the brake, starts, twist over into drive, handbrake comes off automatically, and away we go. As with most electric cars, plenty of power, but fully customizable drive modes. So you can have an eco, custom, so you can decide what characteristics the car has. Normal mode for general driving, or sport mode for that little bit of extra acceleration. So this being the SE, doesn't have built-in navigation, but you've always got Android Auto or Apple CarPlay to give you the most up-to-date navigation systems. Love the two-spoke steering wheel, flat bottom and flat top, which I've never seen before. At the moment, we're in the top level of regeneration. So it's on level three, so there's one, two or three, and three being the strongest set of regen. So when you stop accelerating, the car will decelerate itself the hardest, giving you the maximum energy recovery. Automatic brake hold, so just by pushing harder down on the brake, it locks the brake on. So as soon as I'm ready to go, just touch the accelerator and it releases the brake for you. All the steering wheel controls are customizable, so you can perform different functions depending on your preference or your driving circumstance. It's going to try and escape this traffic in a minute. Hop up onto the A4 and the M4 just so we can get her up to some speed. So just while we're seeing in the traffic, I'll just show you some of the other functions. So at the moment that's on Android Auto, so now we can switch across, go into the vehicle setup. And you can then program some of the functionality on the steering wheels. So the different driving modes you can have. So on these two, they relate to the two star keys on the steering wheel. So this one, you can have it onto controlling your air conditioning, or you can change sources for your music. So at the moment it's set to air conditioning. So whenever I push this button here on the steering wheel, it brings up quick controls for the air control, so I can change the fan speed or temperature without having to take my eyes off the road or touch the screen at all. I'm just going to check that it's set up for the cruise control. Yep, so this one's set up to cruise control. Thank you. cruise control is very simple to use, just by pushing the steering wheel button here, which I've just checked is programmed for the cruise control. As soon as I push that, it activates the cruise control, and then this joystick in this mode controls the speed, so you can go up or down 5 miles an hour. And simply by touching the brake or pushing the steering wheel button again, deactivates the cruise control. A very, very simple car to drive. And as with most modern cars, it has adaptive cruise control, sensing the vehicle in front, slowing down and keeping you at a safe distance. So I'm not actually touching any of the pedals at all at the moment. Now the speed is up to 40, flick it up 5 miles an hour. Very smooth suspension, and as with most electric vehicles, very responsive to the throttle. So the AMG 4 has quite a good range already, so generally keeping it in eco mode will maximise your range, but since we're about to go back on the motorway, let's put it in sport. So just getting her up to speed now. Instant acceleration. Very smooth suspension, very comfortable car to drive. Just about the right amount of space for passengers and in the boot. So now we've been out for a drive, we're just going to head back to the dealership so you can see where we are, and I'll go through some of the interior features and the key points of the vehicle when we get there. So welcome to the interior of the MG4. Just a quick look at the layout of the car, very simplistic design, very attractive. Two-spoke steering wheel, flat bottom, flat top, which I particularly like. And the programmable functions on the steering wheel controls are very, very good. You can decide which buttons control which before you set off and adapt them for different journeys. Lights on the left, wipers on the right, as you'd expect. Driving the car couldn't be easier. Just jump straight in as long as you've got the key. Foot on the brake, system ready, twist it to drive, and away you go. When you finish the journey, just hit park, get out, lock the car, and it turns everything off for you. Handbrake comes on and off automatically, which is a particularly nice feature. You can manually take control should you wish. Built into the SE, which this is, doesn't have a built-in satellite navigation, which the Trophy does, but of course you've got Google, Android Auto and also Apple CarPlay should you wish. Home button here takes you to your main screen, which shows you some basic functions. You can change the temperature of the car, change the fan speed. You can see the amount of discharge of the battery as well. Also across here you've got volume controls and your basic heating functions. So front heater, rear heater, this brings up your heating systems here. Now what I do like is you've also got the programmable system on the steering wheel. So if I hit this button here, so I've programmed this star on the right steering wheel control to bring up the air controls. So that will then bring you up basic systems like turning the volume, the fans up or down, and also the temperature. As you can see from here, temperature, fan speed, up or down. And then that gets rid of it again. This steering wheel joystick here will generally, when it's not functioning, the air conditioning will control your media and also the ringtone for your phone. Bluetooth controls are over here. And this one you can have set to control your cruise control systems, making it very easy just to change your speed when you're on a cruise while you're driving along. Other functionality of this screen, so that's your main home screen. If you swipe left like so, it brings up some more advanced functions. So you can go into vehicle. Here you can change your drive mode, so you can have snow, which might come in useful soon, hopefully. Eco, which I've normally got mine in. If you do want to go a little bit faster, you can pop it into sport. It gives you maximum acceleration. Normal driving, just for poodling around town. And eco primarily is really for sort of motorway cruising, just to maximize your battery life. So you've got a handy little pad here for resting your phone down. So when you've got it used, when you're using CarPlay or Android Auto, you can plug your phone in there. On the Trophy, the top of the range, this is also a wireless charging pad, making it even more useful. There is a USB socket down here for charging or for connecting to CarPlay or Android Auto, and also a USB-C, which most modern devices will come with for charging. So thanks very much for watching the video. Hope you like the car as much as we do, and we'll see you soon. Bye.